I opened my eyes and blinked. The glare from the bright lights above me blinded me for a few seconds. I looked around me, wondering where I could be. It took a while before I realized where I was. I was in a hospital room. I could hear the beeping of a machine that I was wired up to. The last thing I remembered was waving goodbye to my mom and dad as they dropped me off at the bus station. But before I go on, stop right there. You. Yes, you. Subscribe to the channel right now and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on any of our awesome stories. Alright, back to the video. I pressed the call button on the table next to my bed. A few seconds later, a doctor and two nurses came into the room.
How are you feeling? Asked the doctor.
I'm okay, I think, I said.
Are you up to seeing your family?
Yes, definitely. The doctor went outside. A few minutes later, he came back in, but instead of bringing my family, he brought some strangers.
Where are my family? The doctor looked at me. Marcus, this is your family. Don't you recognize them?
That's not my mom and dad. I don't know these people.
Marcus, we are your family, the man said. You have been in a coma for 6 months.
The man went on to tell me that I had been going to visit my grandparents, but the bus that I was traveling on crashed and overturned. I was lucky to escape with my life. I had no idea why they were saying they were my family. I knew what my parents looked like, and it certainly wasn't this couple. I knew I had to get out of the hospital and find my real family.
Could you please get me something to drink? I just need a bit of time by myself to process all this.
Of course, Marcus. Come on, darling, let's go to the cafeteria, said the woman. As soon as the couple left the room, I jumped out of bed. I ripped the wires out of my arm and ran out of the room. I had to get out of the hospital. I ran down the corridor looking for a way out, but every time I turned a corner, it just led to more rooms. I was starting to panic. I knew it wouldn't be long before someone realized I was missing. I finally saw the exit doors ahead of me, but just before I got to them, an alarm sounded and the shutters came down. There was no way I could get out now. It wasn't long before I was surrounded by doctors and nurses. Where are you going? You're not well. You must come back to your room. I had no choice but to do as they said. When I got back there, the man and woman were waiting for me.
Why did you run away, Marcus?
I know you're not my parents. I need to find my family.
Look, we will show you some photos. Maybe then you'll believe us.
The woman opened her bag and took out a handful of photos. They were all photos of me at various stages of my childhood, and in each one, I was with the man and the woman.
Now do you believe us? Asked the man.
I nodded and sat back down on the bed. It was obviously true. They were my parents, but who were the people in my memories then? It was about a week later when the doctors finally said I was allowed to go home. I watched out of the car window as we drove the familiar streets. When I got to my house, I recognized it straight away. It felt good to be home. I went up to my room. All my things were exactly as I remembered them. Everything was just as it should be, except I still had these strange, niggling doubts. I had memories of being in this house, but my parents looked different in my memories. The doctor had told me that this sometimes happens when someone has been in a coma. He hoped that one day my memory would be normal again, but some people never get it back. I was excited to go back to school. I couldn't wait to see all my friends again. As I walked into the playground on my first morning back, I was immediately surrounded by all of my friends.
How have you been? I can't believe you were in a coma for 6 months. That's crazy, said Nick, my best friend.
I know, it's mad, isn't it? I said, but I'm back now. You need to tell me everything that I've missed. Nick filled me in on what had been going on while I was in the hospital.
Marcus, I've missed hanging out with you.
I know, why don't I come over to your house this weekend? We can play computer games and watch movies just like we used to.
That sounds like a great plan, but I better check with my parents first. I'll let you know tomorrow.
When I got home from school, I went to ask my mom if I could invite Nick over on the weekend.
Oh no, I don't think that's a good idea, Marcus. You really need some more time to recover from your accident.
I was disappointed, but I knew mom was only doing what she thought was best for me. When I told Nick that my mom had said no, he was disappointed too.
What? I can't believe it, said Nick. Your parents always let me spend time at your house.
I know, they're just being a bit weird after my accident. I guess they're just being overprotective. I know. I'll ask my mom if I can go into town on Saturday. We could meet up for a pizza or something.
Okay, sounds like a plan.
Mom said it was okay for me to go into town. So on Saturday morning, I set off bright and early. I wasn't meeting Nick until 11 o'clock, but I wanted to look around the shops for a bit first. I was looking in the window at some new sneakers when I suddenly saw the reflection of a woman. My heart dropped. I turned around and called out to her, "Mom!" The woman turned and looked at me, but then she ran off down the street. I crossed the road and ran after her, calling out as I went, "Mom, please stop. I just want to talk to you." But she just kept on running. She turned a corner into an alleyway. But when I got to the corner and went around, I couldn't see her anymore. Where could she have gone? I thought. The alley was empty. I felt so confused. In my memories from before my coma, she was the woman who I recognized as my mother. Not the strangers back home, but they showed me pictures of me as a kid with them. So they had to be my parents, right? Then who was the couple in my memories? Who was my real family? I didn't tell my parents about the woman. I knew they would probably be annoyed with me. There was definitely something going on, and I was going to find out what it was. The next morning, my parents went out early. As soon as I heard the car drive off, I went into their room. I began looking through drawers and cupboards, but I couldn't find anything. Suddenly, I spotted a key dangling on a piece of string inside Mom's cupboard. I took it out. I wondered if it would open the drawer in my dad's office that was always kept locked. Well, there was only one way to find out. I went downstairs and into Dad's office. I put the key in the lock and turned it. I heard the click as the key unlocked the drawer. Nervously, I pulled the drawer open. What I saw inside shocked me. There was a huge stack of photos, the same photos that they had shown me when I was in the hospital. Except this time, the photos were of me and the family that I remembered. They had obviously taken them and photoshopped their own faces to replace my real family. When they came home, I was sitting in the lounge waiting for them. I had the photos in my hand. As soon as they came in, they could see that something was wrong. "Marcus, what have you got there?" asked Dad, or the man who claimed to be my dad. "I know what you've done. You photoshopped these to convince me that you are my family. Where are my real parents?" They had no choice but to admit what they had done. "Look, you're right, we did, but you have to trust us. It was for your own good. Everything will be okay." "Okay, I trust you," I said, but I was lying. I didn't trust them at all, but I didn't want them to know. I had to find out where my real parents were. The next morning, I got up at the crack of dawn and left the house. I'd written them a note and put it on the kitchen table. "I'm going to find my real parents. I have to know the truth," it said. I went to the area where I had seen my mom. I started knocking on all the house doors, showing people the photos of my parents and asking if anyone had seen them around. But no one had. I spent hours and hours asking everyone until finally I had no more energy left. I went back to the motel room that I had rented. I would get a good night's sleep and then start again the following morning. But when I got to the room, I saw a note had been pushed under the door. "Meet us at the park tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. Love, Mom and Dad." My heart jumped with joy. They wanted to see me. I was so excited I could hardly sleep that night. The next morning, I set off for the park. I thought they would already be there when I arrived, but I looked around and couldn't see anyone. I had been there less than a minute when someone grabbed me from behind. I tried to break free from them, but they were too strong. They bundled me into a car and drove off. "Where are you taking me? Who are you?" "Just keep quiet and you'll be okay," the man said. The car stopped and the two men got out. They pulled me out of the car and took me into a derelict building. "Have you got my parents? They wrote me a note. I was supposed to meet them in the park." "It wasn't your parents that left the note. It was us," said the man. My face fell in shock. "Why would you do that?" "Because your parents are undercover agents. They're looking for us, so we kidnapped you to use as a ransom." "What are you talking about? My parents aren't secret agents." The man took out his phone and called a number. "We have your son. Give up looking for us or we will hurt him and you will never see him again." "Mom, Dad, help me!" I screamed. The man cut off the call. "Be quiet or you will regret it." I didn't say another word. I was shaking with fear. I had no idea how this was all going to end. Suddenly, I heard a loud crash. Someone had kicked the door in. Within seconds, the room had filled with policemen. "You're under arrest. Put your hands in the air." Once the police had got the handcuffs on the two men, they called out, "It's safe. You can come in now." "Marcus," I looked up. "Mom, Dad." My mom came running over and put her arms around me. "Are you okay?" I nodded, tears running down my eyes. "I'm so happy to see you," I cried. "How did you find me?" Dad told me that when the two men had called them, the police had been able to trace the phone call. It hadn't taken them long to find the building I was being held captive in. "I'm sorry we had to do this to you," said Dad. He began to explain exactly what had happened. They told me that it was true that they were secret agents. After my accident, they had gone undercover on a very important mission for the government. "When you came out of your coma, we were at a critical moment. We couldn't come to see you because our true identities would be revealed. We asked two other agents to go to the hospital and convince you that they were your parents. I was shocked at what they told me. I'm so sorry I came looking for you. I hope I haven't ruined everything, I said. Actually, you've done us a big favor. If you hadn't gone looking for us, showing our photos to everyone in the area, the two men would never have known you were our son. They couldn't resist the temptation to kidnap you and try to use you against us. But their plan backfired. Now they will be going to prison for a very long time. Does that mean you'll be coming home? I asked. Yes, it does, said Mom, smiling. The three of us drove home together. When we got there, my fake mom and dad were sitting, waiting for us. I'm sorry I didn't trust you, I told them. Now I know that you were just taking care of me until my real parents were able to come home. You don't need to apologize. We're just happy that you're safe and back with your real family now. Oh, and I'm sorry we didn't let you bring Nick home. We just couldn't risk him seeing us and telling you that we weren't your real parents. What did you think about that story? Crazy, right?